Hi guys, I'm just finishing off this what I call layers effect bright cut penny, and something I've been doing recently. Let me just jump straight into it. So I'm using the homemade hand engraver machine, and I'm just going to cut to the edge. Now the thing is with a powered graver is you can keep the power on. Alright, so this will be perfect. Hang on. Right, so I'm going to cut up to this line. So, and then I'll do it on this as well, but I'll just show you. Right, now what am I going to do? Now watch this bit. Right. So what I'm doing, I'm still keeping the power on the foot pedal, but I'm holding the graver back. The only analogy I can give is if you take a dog for a walk and he's trying to run away and you're pulling the lead back, or a kid as well. So that's the feel. So the power's on. Now the power's on, I'm in the metal. I was watching the camera there, I've got to watch the thing right. So let me do a few and I have to get the knack of it. So right, the power's on, I'm moving. The power's still on, but I'm kind of pulling it back, because it wants to go forward, but I'm pulling it back. What that does is, if you think you've got to move, because I've only discovered this recently, you think you've got to move constantly and time it just right. You have to a certain extent to break the chip off. So what you'll probably find is when you're starting, you'll go like this, and like this is slowed down. Oh, you go like that and then you hit the other side. Don't worry about that, but ultimately what you got to do is get to the edge. It's just going to give away. You'll dive down, it's still there, but you just break that off. So when that's darkened, that will be one continuous black line. But what you can do to in some instances, this bit that's left is so weak that you fall down it anyway and bump the side. But if you find you're doing that, you do this technique of holding it back. So this is what I'm going to do now. I'm going to hold it back. So I'm come to the edge, I'm holding it back, so I've got nice control, and then I let it go. Just so there's a tiny little weak bit there. So hold it back. So I'm exaggerating, I'm pulling it back, but what I'm doing, it's a subtle. So what that does in this circumstance is, because I just decided it looks nice if I cut right up to the edge. So if you don't use that technique, the danger is you go past. I mean, don't really matter with this, but it's what I want to do, the effect I want. So here, I'm pulling it back. So I'm just going, so now I know it's ready to go, that little chip, and then broke it off. So that should improve if you find your it's running away with you, the graver. So come to the end, right, come back. It's not quite the technique I was, because you can get it so it's in kind of like all in one movement. So this is just timing it to break off just at the right time, but a little bit of pulling back there. So there, it's just about to get, you can feel it, it's just about to give. So that will be a good ultimately you want to get quick, but the aim is not to be quick in engraving, but the more you practice, the quicker you'll get. But that's not the main focus. But you want to be accurate. So you can keep the power on. So I'm keeping the power on. If I relax my hand, the graver will go forward, but I'm kind of holding it back by, I'm just analysing what I'm doing. So I'm holding the back by kind of, I don't know. You just have to get a feel for it. So you got power on, but it's not moving. That's showing up quite well there. I'm exaggerating a little bit, but you'll see it wants to go forward, but I'm pulling it back. Let's see if we can get. Yeah, that's good. Right. You'll probably see. Right, you see there, because I've got quite a high powered handpiece in. It's jerky, but so see, but any time I relax my hand, it just. Right, I'll show you one more, see if it explains it better, because you'll see. You'll appreciate that the a powered graver or the homemade hand engraved machine requires no forward effort on your part, and to a certain extent, if you do push while you're using this, it will have a negative effect. Not all, I do push sometimes if I'm impatient, but that's not the purpose. So right, so I can I can't show you now. Alright, let's do that. Right, right, so there you go. Right, let's hold it like a pen. So it's still going forward. Look at this bit. Right, I've got to hold it up. Right, I'm not pushing. So the idea is you hold it back. It wants to go. Oh. Right, I'll zoom in on this guy so you can see it. Right, oh, it looks good there. Right, so this, I can imagine a lot of people hate this. I mean, at one time I wouldn't have liked this kind of like 60s whatever psychedelic thing, but it's brilliant for something to do. And if you can get a nice tidy engraving at the end of it, then you're getting somewhere. So yeah, you could do one of these if you're starting out. You could do one of these. Less oh, some porosity in the coin there. There we are. Let's say it wouldn't look that great, but then in another say 10 hours, try another one and see how you're getting on. Take it out and show you. Let me show you this graver I'm using. Actually, I just swapped over. I normally use the Rick Alexander, but I accidentally cut the spring up for that one. I had a perfect spring for it, and I took it out to clean it, and then I didn't realise it was the one that meant to go back in there and did something else with it. But anyway, this is a he changed his username anyway. Begins with G. Oh, I forgot his name there, but sent me this. But I'll just show you because it's such a simple. I mean, ignore it. It's a nice handle he's got there. So, but ignore that. So it's just a handle. You could get like an old doorknob and make a handle. But let me just show you. So it's got a GRS quick change fitting that goes in there, but that wouldn't be necessary. And Ralph, that was his name. For some reason, I think his surname begins with G. But Ralph, so Ralph from Germany sent me this. If he's listening, thanks, Ralph. So it's just a how did he make it now? Right, so it's a brass tube, and he soldered. I think he soldered another steel tube in there, so it creates a step. So that's something you could do without a lathe, and then it's just a tap. You could buy. I did buy. It's a full. I think this is a 14 millimeter. I don't know. It's tap and die thing. But let me show you the. Right. So, just a. I won't take it out. It's just a cheap old spring. You can buy a box of springs in a pound shop. And this is the piston that I made. So what that was is a bolt, a nut and bolt. So that's the nut there that's gone round. So I screwed it on and I ground it all down. And it's not that brilliant a fit. It doesn't have to be, well, oh, it's not bad. If you put your mouth over that and suck and blow, it will come back. So it's quite a good fit. But the reason why I made it is for the power. So you can see this concentrating the power, and it pokes right through. Can you see there's that where that hole is, there's a step. So that's where the tube went on the inside. Right, and it's, I'm using some will know, I converted a dog watering fountain thing into a foot pedal for the homemade machine, and that's what I'm using. So you've got the best of everything, a lot of power, and it's controllable. That's what you, it's okay having a lot of power, but you've got to be able to control it. So with a decent foot pedal and that technique, you know, and practice. Right, it's not so neat, but this come out really neat. So it's practicing the technique and developing it all the time. But so you got that effect. So that was just a straight coin, the original oxide, and just cut through it. And if you make a mistake with this, you can just cut right over it. I mean, I could recut that in a different, totally different pattern, and you go deep enough. This bit come out really neat of developing this bit here, and that bit's interesting. But it's basically steering the graver. So if you're not interested in this, if you do it, it'll help with what you are interested in. Right, guys, hope that helps. Cheers, everybody. Bye.